Hello, it's me again, I'm Nafit. In our previous video, we have explained what is template base and how the template will apply the variables to the switch and then how the switch gets updated by the template. I left a link here for you to go and visit that video. And I would like in this video to just move on from the previous one, look how to modify the variables file to accommodate the new switch. Add a new switch to the template group. So we have two switches now, and verify settings and see how the new switch updated gets updated by the variables that have been set inside the template and that is being affected by the variables file that we have modified. Let's have a look. So in our previous video, we've seen there was one switch in the group and we could apply the template with variables. Now we have another switch which is still unprovisioned, and that switch is still not a member of the group. What we need to do is basically we need to apply the same template to the other switch. Now we've changed the variables. So what we in this case need to do, we need to download the variable file. So that variables file, we need to have a section that belongs to the other switch. So the other switch serial number is this. We have to make sure there's a section populated inside the variables file correspond to the new switch. So if you have 10 switches, you need to have 10 sections in that JSON formatted variables file. I'll show you what I mean by this. So that's the variables file. We originally had this only. So we had this only. I've added a new section here. That correspond to the other switch. So remember this switch, this is the serial number for the new switch, and if you look back into central, this is the serial number of the new switch with this MAC address. So this will make sure that each switch, that's a MAC address we have. Now, if you have 10 of these switches, you would have created 10 sections, 10 areas like this. So what we've done, in the previous one, in the previous, the original switch, the variables file that correspond only to one switch, now it corresponds to two switches. And these are the values for the variables. You notice these values are not equal to these values. Meaning now, when the new switch gets added to the group, it will pick up all the settings that are here. And these have to correspond to the new switch, so the serial number correctly done, 100%. And the template header has to be, of course, adjusted towards the new switch. Now, if you look at the new switch now, show system. That's a new switch. That's the serial number. That's a MAC address here. We can issue the command show VLAN. These are the VLANs. Now, when we add the switch to the group, it will pick up all settings for the VLANs. We wanted the VLANs to exist as are. So 20.21.202.222.2, but the names would be different now because the switch would be managed and influenced by the group. Template file, yeah. So if we click on this switch, that's the one. So we go back. If we go to the groups, and in the groups we should see the list of devices. One is unprovisioned with, which is our switch. We're gonna go and move it to the group. So here. This is our group. We will move it to this group. Now that group contains two switches, switch one and switch two. We'll go back to the group. So that's the group. So we go back to the config. We will upload the newly created template file, variables file. Again, remember template apply or is applicable to both switches. What is the difference now? We need to upload the new or newly edited variables file, which is this one. That has been uploaded. Now, let's make sure that this switch is managed by Central, definitely, because we could see it in Aruba Central. It's not connected, so we're gonna go Aruba. Otherwise, will not be any. It has changed the name switch 2. And let's have a look at the VLAN, show VLANs. These are the newly created VLANs. They are not newly created, but these are influenced by the variables that are in the switch, in the variables file, which are here. So if we refresh this page, or even without refreshing, you notice a new section has been added corresponding to the new switch. Okay, so that's how we can manage multiple switches in one template, in one group. We can push settings based on the variables file and the sections in the variables file that correspond, each one of them correspond to a switch. And we have, because we have two switches, each one of them is identified by the serial number. That's the one. In this video, we have explained how the template can be applicable to multiple switches in the group, and how is that achievable using the variables file and multiple entries in the variables file. And then we looked at how the impact, how to update the switch on that one. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and thank you very much for watching this video. We'll see you in future videos. Thank you.